things going on, too. We took you to Sinisippi, of course, outside the conservatory. So many beautiful lights out there. Now, we are at Anderson Japanese Gardens with, of course, Elliot Grandia, who was just chilling by the fire. I've noticed, though, Elliot, you're staying indoors. Is it colder than we think out there?
Yeah.
You know, it's not so bad, but sometimes, you know, the Midwest winter kind of hits you across the face a little bit, so you got to be more prepared. I found a hat randomly in my desk. I was lucky, and I had my work coat, so we're just enjoying the inside because that is part of the fun that you can have at the Anderson Japanese Gardens. You can explore all the gardens, see all the lights for the first time. It's the first time they're ever doing that, but then you can come in here, see this beautiful tree, sit by the fire. There's lots to do inside as well, and you can even, you were just there, Whitney, you can look outside the windows and enjoy it from the warmth inside if you're not into the cold. So I've got John here with us. It's a big year for the Anderson Japanese Gardens because this is the first time you guys are ever doing anything like this.
Yeah, this is the first time we're open in the off season that we call it. So the winter time, it's the first time we're open at nighttime for guests to come in and enjoy the gardens. It's the first time we're putting lights up. So there's a lot of firsts.
Yeah, and you guys are doing so much. You guys had a huge summer. You know, this has been a pandemic and the Anderson Gardens were a perfect place for people to go outside, you know, socially distant, walk around, and you were saying you guys saw bigger crowds than you've really seen in a long time.
Yeah, we definitely had a lot of people turn out to enjoy the gardens, whether it be just because it was an outside event experience or because it's just a place you can come and kind of find peace from the craziness of everything. But we had all of our Tuesday evening came back. We did a limited version of it, 9 weeks out of the usual 14. Our Halloween event was really big. We had a jack-o'-lantern contest with a bunch of different local schools. So we had a lot of people enjoy the garden and really come out and enjoy the outdoors.
Yeah, definitely the cool thing about what you guys are doing is you involve the community. You're involving schools for the jack-o'-lanterns. You're involving choirs.
Yep.
This year. They're going to come out and be caroling on the weekends. Tell me a little bit about why that's so important to really involve a lot of, you know, different parts of the community.
So one thing that we wanted to do with the different schools is a lot of the schools and people who are in the Rockford area maybe might not be aware that the gardens exist here. So for the students, at least, it's a nice way to get them to come here, experience the garden, experience the beautiful landscapes, and then maybe get a little bit of you know, education on the Japanese culture and how do they do their design styles and everything like that. So it's just kind of like opening it and expanding their horizons to see what's in their backyard and how they can come and enjoy it in a different way.
Yeah, definitely. I'm not going to call him my photographer, but this is his first time, and he's loving it so far. He's already saying he's going to come back for the winter event here. So once people are inside, there's also lots to do, lots of ways to cozy up. I heard you were saying some maybe an alcoholic beverage if you want that.
Yep. So Fresco is going to be open for the first time as dinner. They're going to be doing a dinner service, and they're also going to have hot chocolate that you can get in a variety of different ways. And then also, if you are want to stay outside, Rockford Roasting Company is going to be outside in our pavilion area serving up some specialty coffees and some hot chocolate as well. But dinner service in here will be nice. You can come in, grab something to eat, then stroll, or vice versa. Go out and stroll, come in and grab something to eat.
Yeah, so it's a great date night opportunity, very romantic with the fire, or bring out the whole family and have fun, listen to some carols. You guys, so much to do here. We're going to explore some of the other options in just a little bit. But Whitney, Alexis, I think this is going to be a good place for you guys to come out to.
Yeah, we're just saying, like, all of that sounds great, too. We want to see the outside, Elliot. You're going to take us out there, get that hat back on.
We might put the hat back on.
Okay.
We'll see.